Okay, hey, this is Mark coming to you from Baker's Green Acres. Right now, me and Jim and Frank are doing something that I talk about a lot, but I don't think I really show it very much. And today's the day that I'm going to show that. And it's water distribution systems. Yeah, water distribution. A lot of your energy, you know, human energy or boy energy, can get used up pretty quick hauling water. And if you've got plants that need water, animals that need water, just in this pen alone, there's 24 animals, and they go through a lot of water a day. I'd say a pig will probably go through about 4 gallons of water a day, 4 or 5. So if you're hauling, so what we do is we use the distribution system and we run the water all over the farm. Now, let me show you some of the parts. Jim's doing his thing here. This is poly pipe, PVC, polyvinyl chloride, a few engineering weenies out there. We use the thin stuff. And I'm going to recommend that you use the thin stuff. There's two kinds. It's rated in pounds per square inch. Get the lower one. Get the skinny stuff. And the reason why is because the thicker stuff, when you run over it and it's cold, it cracks. This stuff, when you run over it, just squishes and then it comes back. So this stuff is cheap. It is durable as can be. And if it gets damaged, which I have a chunk to fix today that I scraped down through a place where it was kind of shallow and hit it with the plow, the snow plow, and I scraped the chunk off. So I got to scab in a piece. It's no big deal. It's no big deal at all. And let me show you some of the parts that we pick up. They're available every place. They're PVC as well. I mean, this is a union, 49 cents. The most expensive part is the clamps, the hose clamps. And this one is 69 cents. So I've done some of this that I did it when I got here. As a matter of fact, we're adding on right now to a piece of water line that I put in when we first moved here. We first moved in. And I'm taking the clamps off, and these are chrome plated clamps, and they work fine. I mean, and they're 15 years old and they've been buried, and they haven't been buried deep too. When you bury stuff deep, there's no water on it, and you bury it shallow, then it's got a lot of water on it and moisture, and it's always has a tendency to rust. But 15 years and these things don't sure show any sign of wear or imminent breakdown at all. So here's what we have. And then we need this piece here. That's a corner. And you can see that's threaded. 3/4 inch for one of these. This is a spigot. That's how it's spelled. Spigot. Spigot. I always thought it was a spigot. And then these clamps right here. You don't have to do this. You can just use duct tape or wire or whatever, but these have a nice professional appearance. These you put a nice screw in to the fence post that it's going to run up. And in this case right here, we've had no water to this field at all. So we've been using a hose from over there about 30 feet. And the hose is right through this driveway here, and you're driving over it all the time, and or somebody will disconnect it, and or they'll need a hose someplace else, and then they'll take it so you don't have it, you know. And there's animals in here that have to be watered every single day. And I got a really cool email from a guy. I'm gonna look it up. I don't remember your name right now, but it was a really cool farm hack on how to make a waterer out of the tops of the totes that we cut off for our storage containers. And this guy came up with a really neat idea. So I'm going to show that. We kind of tweaked it a little bit because he had it set up so you'd actually have to do it every day. You'd actually have to fill it. And, you know, with as much water in as we do, we like to make it so that a guy can just have it turned on and you can walk by it and make sure there's water in it, but you don't have to actually stop. You know, there's automatic valves that'll shut off when they get, and I can show those. They're really easy. They're about $15, and they last a long time. But the trick is to keep the pigs away from them. That if the pigs can get at anything that doesn't shock them, they'll drag it around and chew on it and try to wreck it best they can. I think that at some point in my farming career, I'm going to figure out a way to build a device that pigs will chew on and drag around and try to wreck, and in so doing, they will generate electricity. Yeah, I haven't quite figured that one out, but I'm working on it. Okay, so this here is a pretty standard assembly. You know, we put that on with hose clamps. You can see that, just one hose clamp. There are other methods to do that, but this is the one that's available to me. And this one's kid friendly. If a kid has to fix it, they can do it. On that note, I mean, these guys are helping me today, but they're actually learning this. This is a great technology to know. And you can see they're the guys that dug the hole. And, you know, they didn't exactly snap a line on that hole or anything. But this stuff is flexible, so it doesn't really matter if that hole is completely straight. As a matter of fact, that's got kind of a dog leg in it a little bit, but that's how boys do things. But it'll be fine. And but the water line issue is something that really needs some thought. I mean, people need to, if you're in this small farms game, you need to give this some thought, because once this is in, it's in. It's part of the farm. Now I can just hear it right now. Well, you're only burying it 4 inches deep. Ain't that going to freeze in the wintertime? Absolutely going to freeze in the wintertime. But this is just our summer watering system. See, we don't irrigate trees in the wintertime. We don't irrigate the garden. We don't water the pigs in the wintertime because we have so much snow. Unless there is a problem and we have no snow and it's really cold, then we have to water the pigs. And that's where we have a big tub that we put in the bucket of the loader and we bring it out. And you have to do that every day. And I may do that for a month, but not every day. Not every day. The alternative to this would be to trench in lines at 6 feet or 4 or 5 feet and then have frost freeze everywhere, frost free spigots. The problem with frost free spigots is they're susceptible to freezing, especially if the water gets leaked right by the base of them. So the only way you can do that to run any kind of automatic water in the wintertime is you have to have heat there, and then it gets costly and you got to check it, because if something goes wrong and it's cold out and you have water spraying every place, then you really have problems. And I think it's more trouble than it's worth. I have frost freeze at a couple of locations, but I'm very protective of that.
Okay, in the wintertime.
So for this, you will need a shovel, a hammer, a rake, and then the necessary fittings and the line, the 3/4 inch line. We use 3/4 inch for we call these root lines because we put them at the root of the fence. What's nice about them is if you want to add on, you can. You just have to dig it up, find it, put a union in, and you're ready to go. This line here is the one that we've had, and you can see I'm going to lay that over, put a union on it, and connect it up to the new line that the boys are busy doing. See, there's one of the boys over there, busy. But we have a completely different irrigation system for the produce area, and it's it's from the pond, and it's a pump, and it's completely different. The water that's in this comes out of the farm well, which is south of the house, and it's a little bit deeper. It actually comes to the house as well, so we drink the water, and it's good water. This stuff, this PVC, polyvinyl chloride, they make two grades of it. They're both PVC though. And one grade is for that you can drink out of, potable for human beings. The other grade is not. We've held them side by side, smelled them, burned them. The only thing that's different about them is the price, and it's hefty. So PVC is PVC, polyvinyl chloride is polyvinyl chloride. And that's where it ends. So we've been using this for years. This kid's been drinking out of it, and he's only 4 years old. Look at the size of him. The other one's just an infant. Look at the size of him. So they do okay on it. The animals do okay on it. All right, this is Mark from Baker's Green Acres. Remember, anyone can farm.